Well, where are the jobs these days? That's a question millions of Americans are asking. The website The Ladders, which focuses on jobs that pay more than $100,000 a year, just did a study to find out where the best hiring markets are. Mark Senadella is the founder of Ladders.com, and he's also author of the book You're Better Than Your Job Search. He joins us now with the results. Thanks for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
Where are the jobs?
So we looked at the most favorable hiring markets across the country and found that Washington, D.C., Boston, San Francisco, and Seattle were the most favorable hiring markets for six-figure jobs in the country right now in the month of September.
So when you highlight those markets, is that government hiring, healthcare, technology? What are the industries?
So the industries driving it in D.C., it's defense, aerospace, IT, and software. And then across the country, it's really software and IT. And in Seattle, also a strong retail and e-commerce segment with Nordstrom's and Amazon being present there in Seattle.
Are those temporary jobs or these permanent positions?
Permanent positions. And how we determine most favorable market is number of job seekers to number of available jobs. And so those are the markets with the most jobs per job seeker at the 100K plus level.
That's interesting. We track the number of jobs lost here at Bloomberg, and total jobs this year, 720,000 when you include both the public and the private sectors together. There are some who say that many corporations overdid the layoffs out of fear during the crisis. Is that what you're seeing?
We're not yet seeing that.
Not hearing that from firms themselves.
So what we've seen is that the market stopped getting worse in September of 2009, a year ago. It's not getting better, but it stopped getting worse. But firms are not yet confident enough in the economy and the regulatory environment to really start adding back to their payroll. So we're not seeing the wholesale high demand for hiring that you saw in 2006 or 2007.
Is it lack of confidence? Because I know that this debate, you know, it goes in economic directions, it goes in political ones. Is it fundamental dislocation in terms of the jobs that are being created? We don't have people to fit into them in terms of skill sets, or is it simply lack of confidence to go out and put someone on the payroll?
When we speak to HR departments and recruiters, it's that lack of confidence in really staffing up to go for the growth. People will replace positions that are open. They're adding a small bit, but we're not seeing companies coming to us and say, we have this new initiative, we need 50, 100, 200, 300 people in various functions to help us out.
And what are the packages looking like? I mean, besides salary, you know, you look at $100,000 and up. I mean, is this substantially reduced in terms of retirement benefits and health care and whatnot?
They're narrowly reduced. At the margin, somebody who was making $135,000 3 years ago might find that they're getting offers for $130 or $125 in some cases. But the productivity of your employees is so important that really cutting back on 401k or on the benefits isn't really a winning move for a lot of companies.
And as we leave you here, what's the age group that's getting hired? Because there is that fear of those baby boomers and those over 50 not finding employment.
I've been in online recruitment for 10 years, and the fact of age discrimination really is a problem in this country.
Is it more so now?
Consistent, I think, over the last decade. But it's really difficult for folks over 50 to get their hat back into the ring once they're out on the sidelines.
Scary thing to hear for the baby boomers and for the children who may be supporting them. But it's a story that we'll continue to track. Thanks for coming on and highlighting some bright spots for us.
Okay.
We like to find them.